We're going to start in Lubbock, Texas today. Craig, you are on the air. Hi, Craig.
Hey, Bob and Bob. How are you guys doing?
Hey, Craig.
We're doing well. How are you, my friend?
I'm doing fine. I just had a quick question for you. I have recently heard, I actually am a registered nurse who works in an emergency room here in Lubbock. And, of course, we deal with the COVID thing quite extensively. And, you know, it's a nasty customer. And so what I heard the other day was a pastor out of a mega church out of, I guess, I was Orlando, Florida, somewhere, saying that telling his congregation not to take the vaccine because it was a precursor to the mark of the beast. Now, I don't know where to go with this and what to think about it.
Well, I'll just jump in right there, Craig, and say that's baloney. It is not the precursor, and we shouldn't, as Christians, be afraid as far as the mark of the beast is concerned. You and I have already been marked out by God through the Holy Spirit. He has been given to us as a deposit guaranteeing our eternal inheritance. So you've already been marked out by God as someone who belongs to God, someone who has been redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. So it will be impossible for you to take the mark of the beast. Now, when it comes to the mark of the beast, when we read in the book of Revelation, we see that it's something that's on the hand or the forehead. And that's symbolic of belief and action. Belief and action. So our hearts have already been turned to Christ. So we went from unbelievers to believers in Christ. And we live out this new life by faith in Jesus. So we're renewed by the mind. We have the laws of God, the laws of faith, hope, and love written in our hearts and on our minds. And we live that out by the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, there's the way of the world. And there's a belief in the way of this world, a belief in the lies of Satan. And those who live by the lies of this world, by the lies of Satan, they're gonna express, manifest the fruit of evil, aren't they? So when we're talking about marks, we're talking about things that that come from the inside, that start with a belief system. So you, as a believer in Christ, you've already been marked out by the Lord Jesus Christ. You have already been marked as one of his very own. So you don't have to worry about that whatsoever.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Absolutely. It just bothers me when these so-called pastors are, you know, putting this kind of fear into their congregations.
I tell you, Craig, the book of Revelation, you can read it, and it can be very scary. You can get caught up in all the apocalyptic language, and you can come out of a reading of the book of Revelation and be scared to death, walking on eggshells. But that's not why the book of Revelation was written. It was written to be a blessing to anyone who read it. Why is it a blessing? Because we see Jesus for who he really is, high and lifted up. We see him as the Lamb of God slain before the foundation of the world, with everybody bowing to him in worship and praise and glory. We see the protective hand that he has on those who have received him and believed him. And so when you walk through the pages with your eyes fully set on Jesus, you're going to walk a trail of assurance through the book of Revelation. You're going to see time and time and time again that you, as a believer in Christ, have absolutely nothing to worry about. Why? Because in Christ, you have been saved from the wrath to come. That wrath of judgment that is going to be poured out on the lost world. You're not a part of that lost world. You have been rescued from that lost world. You have been taken out of darkness and placed into the kingdom of the Son. You are now light in the Lord. So you've been marked out when you walk through the book of Revelation and you set your eyes firmly on Jesus. It's going to be a walk of assurance from you, for you from beginning to end.